Hi guys, and welcome back. Are you having trouble with your Artillery X1 with your first layers? Well, in this video, I will teach you how to add manual mesh bed leveling to your Artillery X1. So stick around. The first thing you need to do is to download the files that is in the video description. Okay, so after downloading the files, I will walk you through what I changed in the firmware and how to use the manual mesh bed leveling properly.
Okay, so once you have downloaded the files, go to Marlin firmware for X1. Marlin folder. Search for marlin.ino. This will open up the Arduino IDE. Okay, so now we're in the Arduino IDE. I'll just give you a brief rundown of the things I've changed in the firmware. Line 353. The max temp was originally 275, so I changed it to 250. As well as the max bed temp, this was set at 150 by default. I've changed it to 120. The next thing I've changed was the default feed rate for the Z axis. By default, it is set at 50. I changed it to 5. The default acceleration was set to 800, so I dialed it down a bit to 500. The retract acceleration to 1000 and the travel acceleration to 500. The next thing I changed was I uncommented out the probe manually since we will be using mesh bed leveling for this specific printer. Next, we go to line number 980, so I uncommented out mesh bed leveling here. And I also uncommented out the restore leveling after G28. So this specific line of code will load your mesh after the G28. So this is a very useful tool. Okay, so here I changed the inset to 30 so that the first point will be at X30, Y30 of the printer. Okay, so as you can see, by default, it's set at maximum points of 3. This will make a 3x3 grid, which is 9 points. So if ever you want to add more points, this is where you need to change it. And the last thing I changed was I enabled the prompt settings. Okay, so that's all the things I changed in the configuration.h tab. Next, we go to the configuration_advance. We search for baby steps. So you can see I uncommented out baby steps for this. So baby steps enables you to adjust the Z height when printing. Okay, so if ever you see your first layer too high or too low, that's the time you can use baby step in order to correct that problem. Okay, so next and last thing I changed was I enabled linear advance. Okay, so by default this was uncommented out. So I uncommented this. This will enable linear advance for you, but you need to find your specific K factor value. That will be a topic for another video. Okay, so that's everything I changed. You can verify the code by pressing this button. After everything is verified, you can now upload it to your printer.
Okay, so before uploading the code, I forgot to mention this. You need to remove the TFT cable right here, so that the LCD won't interfere when uploading to the MKS Gen. Okay, so I'll get back to you as soon as I'm done uploading. Okay, so after uploading the code, it's now time to put the cable back. Okay, so the next thing we need to do is to flash the new firmware to the TFT screen. Okay, so what you need to do is to open the TFT MBL, copy everything, and paste it to the blank SD card. Okay, so after pasting it, we eject the USB and put the SD card to the TFT slot. So the next thing we'll do is to open the printer and let the firmware flash. Okay, so let me walk you through the
features that I've added in this specific firmware. Okay, if we go to tools and more, you can see there's an option for a PID auto-tune. This is set at 200 degrees Celsius, 10 cycles. After the 10 cycles, you don't have to press save since it is already programmed that it will automatically save those new values to your EEPROM. And next, we have the preheat PLA, as I am mainly using PLA for this specific machine. Save to EEPROM. Next, we have the G29S1. This will bring you to the first point of your mesh bed leveling. Then, you can adjust the Z height. If it's too high, you can actually put it lower or higher depending on the nozzle to paper resistance. If you're done with the first point, then press the G29S2, which brings you to the second to the last point of your mesh. Okay, so aside from the mesh bed leveling, I also enable the baby stepping. You can actually live adjust the Z height during printing. Okay, so that's a added feature with this specific firmware. So let's just wait until it finishes heating up, and I'll get back to you as soon as it's done. Okay, so I am back. Here's the additional features that I have added. If you click on more, there is an option to add a 0.02 or minus 0.02 to your current Z height. Okay, so that will actively change your initial Z height. Okay, so if ever you're done and you're satisfied with the height, just press save and it will automatically save it.
Now I will teach you how to use it properly. First, you need to preheat. You can actually use the preheat PLA function that I've added. I'll just set this here and wait for the printer to heat up. Okay, so I am back. Okay, so the first thing you need to do is to press G29S1. Okay, so grab your piece of paper and move it to this side. Okay, now measure the nozzle to paper resistance. If it's grabbing too tight to the paper, you can press Z plus to move it up. Still not enough. There you go. Once you're satisfied with that point, you can now press G29S2. This will move you to the second point. As you can see, it is not touching the nozzle, so I can move this down. Now that it's touching the nozzle, and I'm satisfied with that paper to nozzle resistance, I'll move to the next point by pressing G29S2 again. This is too high. Let me bring this down. A little more. Okay, next. So basically, you need to repeat this process until you get to the last point, which is at the back right of the printer. Next, the middle part. This is, I know I have a bowed printer on the middle one, so that is binding up. So I can move this up. Up again. It's bowed very much. Okay, so I can move it now. Move to the next point. And this seems to be good. Okay, so do not press G29S2 again. If you're at the last point, what you need to press is the save button. After saving, you can auto home. And print. Thank you. first layer that is been printed already. And as you can see, everything turned out quite nice. Perfect first layer. This is the bottom part. This is the top part. X marks the spot. If you like the content of this video, please hit like, consider subscribing, and as always, keep everything easy.